Details with Adam Sierpinski, and today we're going to be doing dribbling. It's the quintessential means to getting by an opponent, and I believe 2K has made market improvements in the way dribbling is done in the game. Not perfect, but it's very effective. Just like the fact that I can switch hands, just my own little thing. I can do a lot of things just with the directional buttons, just switching hands. That to me is just invaluable. The fact that I can do that makes me happy. Details. This is the in and out. This is amazing because it shows you what the move is supposed to be look like when you're doing it. So if you're a young kid or a grown man trying to improve his game, this allows you to see exactly and mentally rehearse what the hesitation is supposed to look like and what different ways, different types, different particular. Sorry, let me rephrase that. If you're a person trying to improve their game, this helps because it helps you see the categories of different moves and the particular instances of those moves and how they can be very, made different. And with combinatorial variability being the name of the game, you can mix and match these into formidable show-stopping movements. Intricate. The key is let the move finish. Let the animation finish because it's just animation, and you have to understand that the animation is triggered by each click of the button. So you have to let the animation finish, and then you can see the full motion. It's very much basic. The programming isn't that difficult for this. If you really think about what it is, it's that I assign a animation to a function, I guess, and then I just say, all right. Let flick of stick equal function. Done deal. Add all of them, and you have a complex system and architecture that deserves respect. But this was developed over many years, and I've been playing this game since 2K. I was one of the original 2K owners for Dreamcast. Hence why I devote such much attention to details. I've seen them all develop and materialize. Every single detail that has been added to the game, I know when it was added, more or less. I don't really care that much, but it's just one of those things that you notice just from being a bystander, an observer. By observing anything, you become acceptant of its properties. You accept it. So observing is an interesting thing. So by observing something, you become mentally able to perceive it. And to perceive is to feel, and to feel is to think, and to think is to act. Why devote so much time into learning particulars? Because I want to be able to make decisions and really utilize moves for purposive reasons. So my reasoning is purposive. I'm driving to the basket with the purpose of just slamming on fools and scoring. No, or maybe not. Purposes has changed. But still, I want to score points, make them look good, beat opponents. So we work on particulars. So any situation that arises, we're prepared. That was hot, wasn't it? That was pretty hot. We got some that's the NBA twerking. That's the NBA version of twerking, baby. Jay Mitchell with the twerk. No disrespect, but that was funny. I like this move. Never used it before, but that's very useful. One thing I actually play basketball, it's one of my number one things, change of pace. more of a soccer thing. Cristiano Ronaldo is very effective at this. Back as Man U days, Peter Patter all over the place, making people look like absolute vandals. But that ain't my discourse in this specific video. Footwork is important in all sports. Let's see if I can do this more rationally. Move, I stopped up the key. So sprint, let's see if we can make some scenarios happen. So let's say, it's a very tight game. I sprint then stop. Well, would I shoot? I wouldn't necessarily. I would just give my opponent some space, to be perfectly honest. Shoot. I have all the options in the world. That's that. That's how the dribbling works, and we can chain those together to do, some really effective things. Like, not that, but step back, jump shot.